Then Imam Shurum Bilahi Rahmatullah Ali begins with the adab of Ziyarat al-Madinah. It is befitting the person who attends visiting the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to send as much blessings as possible, because he hears them and they reach him. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam hears them and they reach him. And they say amongst the salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he mentions their virtues are so well known as not to require mention, i.e. the salawat, the virtues of the salawat. I.e. the virtues of giving salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are so well known that he doesn't even need to go into that discussion. But when you go to Medina, your focus is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When you go to Mecca, it's istighfar. It's about you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the Kaaba. When you go to Medina, it's about you and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so all the way there, your tongue should be just moistened. You should moisten your tongue with salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of the best salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Jazallahu anna Muhammadan ma huwa ahlu. One of the best salawat to ever send, Jazallahu anna Muhammadan ma huwa ahlu. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam what is befitting for him. What is befitting for him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward him what is befitting for him. And in the hadith in Tabarani, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, whoever says this salah upon me, Jazallahu anna Muhammadan ma huwa ahluhu, at'aba 70 katiban alf sabahin. He will tire out, he will exhaust 70 scribes for a thousand mornings. I 70 angels for 1,000 days will be writing rewards for that person. He says, Jazallahu anna Muhammadan ma huwa ahluhu. Jazallahu anna Muhammadan ma huwa ahluhu. Jazallahu anna Muhammadan ma huwa ahluhu. Some of the ulama, they say when you complete a gathering, because normally people complete a gathering by saying Subhana Rabbika Rabbil Izzati Amma Yasifoon wa Salaamu Alayhi wa Sallam Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen and other ways. But some of the ulama will say if it's a gathering of knowledge, Jazallahu Anna Muhammadan Ma Huwa Ahla. Complete it, finish it with that. Because all of the knowledge that you've gained goes back to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. All of the knowledge that is passed within gatherings comes from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So you're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward him in a befitting manner for what's being, because we're taking, this is all inheritance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is all the estate, the wealth that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam left for us. It's not dirham wala dinar. It's not an inheritance of money. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he went into the souq of Medina, he went into the markets of Medina, and he shouted out to people saying that the estate of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is being distributed in the masjid. So people just closed up their shops and they went to the masjid. And when they went in there and they looked, all they saw was just majalis of dhikr, majalis, gatherings of dhikr, gatherings of knowledge and so on. And they asked him, where is this estate? He said, these are the estates of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is what he's left behind for the ummah. من صلى علي عشر مرات صلى الله عليه 100 مرة صلى الله عليه 100 مرة ومن صلى علي 100 مرة كتب بين عينيه براءة من النفاق وبراءة من النار وأسكنه الله يوم القيامة مع الشهداء. Another hadith in Tabarani, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever sends salat upon me, sends salawat upon me 10 times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send mercy upon him 100 times. Based upon another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من صلى علي مرة صلى الله عليه 10 مرات. Whoever sends one salah upon me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send 10 salah upon you. And remember, as Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he explained what's the meaning of salah. He said, As-salatu min Allahi rahmah, was-salatu min al-malaikat al-istighfar, was-salatu min al-bashar al-du'a. As-salatu min Allahi rahmah. Abdullah ibn Abbas said that the salah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is rahmah. He showers his mercy upon that person. As-salatu min al-malaikat al-istighfar. That the salah of the angels is that they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness for you. وَالصَّلَاةُ مِنَ الْبَشَرْ الدُّعَى. And the salah of human beings is dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَصَلِّ عَلَيْهِمْ إِنَّ صَلَاتَكَ سَكَنًا لَهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the Prophet, do salah upon them. I make dua for them. So the salah, مَنْ صَلَّ عَلَيْهِ عَشْرًا مَرَّاتِ. Whoever sends 10 salah upon the Prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send him 100 mercies will come down upon that person. And then the Prophet said, whoever sends 100 salawat upon me in a day, كُتِبَ بَيْنَ عَيْنَيْهِ بَرَاءَةٌ مِّنَ النِّفَاقِ. Between his eyes, and on his forehead, will be recorded that he's free of hypocrisy, that he's not a hypocrite. وَبَرَاءَةٌ مِّنَ النَّارِ. He's not a hypocrite and he's free from the hellfire. وأسكنه الله يوم القيامة مع الشهداء. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put him in abode on Yawm al-Qiyamah with the martyrs for sending 100 salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in one day. And another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من صلى علي في يوم ألف مرة لم يمت حتى يرى مقعده من الجنة. He says, whoever sends 1,000 salawat upon me in a day, he will not die until he's seen his place in hellfire. He will not die until he's seen his place in paradise. Another hadith, من صلى علي كل يوم ثلاث مرات وكل ليلة ثلاث مرات شوقا حبا وشوقا إلي كان حقا على الله أن يغفر له ذنوب تلك الليلة وذلك اليوم. Whoever sends salawat upon me, 3 salawat in the day and 3 salawat in the night, out of love and out of desire for me. He said, it's the duty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He forgives you, that person's sins during that day and during that night. So the importance of the salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the best book that has been written on this subject by Al-Hafiz Imam Al-Sakhawi rahmatullahi alayhi, the students of Ibn Hajar rahmatullahi alayhi. I've forgotten the title of the book. القول البديع في الصلاة على الحبيب الشفيع. القول البديع في الصلاة على الحبيب الشفيع. And that's recently, it's recently been translated. If you want to get access to it on the it's been published by Amal Press. I don't know what it's called in English, but it's a translation of القول البديع, the most excellent or the most perfect statement في الصلاة على الحبيب الشفيع, about الصلاة upon الحبيب الشفيع. We'll continue next week, inshallah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Is there any questions? Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Whoever sends 10 salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send 100 salawat upon him. And whoever sends 100 salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, between his eyes will be recorded bara'atan min al-nifaq, that he's free of hypocrisy and he's free from the hellfire. Wa askanahu Allahu yawm al-qiyamati ma'a ash-shuhada, and Allah subhanahu will abode him on the day of judgment with the shuhada, with the martyrs. Inshallah, the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa rahmah to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once is enough, inshallah. So rahmah, don't restrict the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once is enough, inshallah. I mean, something you want to do all the time, but inshallah, once is enough. I mean, it's related that one of the Bani Israel, just having that connection to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam can, I mean, it's amazing what he'll do. One of the Bani Israel, this is recorded in one of the commentaries on the Shema'il. So there was a man from the Bani Israel who was considered the worst fasiq of his time, and he did sins and he couldn't even care less about them. And when he died, they threw his body away. They didn't even bury him in the proper manner. They threw his body away. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired to the Prophet, why did you do that? Return him back and pray his janazah and honor him. And the Prophet said that he openly flouted your laws. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, one day in his life, he read the scriptures and he came across the name Muhammad in the scriptures and he kissed the name Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And because of that, I forgave him all of his sins. Because of that. And that's just one action in connection to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So I mean, even if you say it once in your lifetime, inshallah, we hope it's sufficient. Because the attachment to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is key to the attachment to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
So
those
are
hadith,
they're authentic, yeah?
I mean, those hadith are weak hadith, but we say in the fada'il, the weak hadith is fine. And that's the majority of the ulama, that in fada'il a'mal, weak hadith is fine, it's accepted. Thank you.